come. Show me your strength. Show me your resolve!
Hi, friend.
You can see your death from there! Can you take care of this? I need to put on more lip balm.
Really? Yeah?
I can see the depth.
That's a... Good boss fight. Good mechanic. So he has a huge knockback that literally throws you off of the map. So this is basically an amalgamation of all the worlds he's stolen. I noticed that as I came in here. Really? Is there a way to not have that happen? Because I feel like this is just, I'm just gonna fucking die because I get like 400 damage on him, then he knocks me off the map. I guess I just have to put my back to something that doesn't, like over there or something, where he can't hit me off the map. What is this? No. That is not what I wanted. Yeah, now he can't knock me off the map. That's good. Does he not have a crit spot? Huh. Phase 2.
Very good indeed. But alas, I'm quite desperate to succeed, and pride is not my weakness.
Huh.
No, I'm afraid it's not over yet.
Man, I know exactly what's about to happen.
Don't look down, don't look down!
Man. This is what they thought was a good idea. Basically, they took all the bosses that we've already fought, threw them into their section of this mini-map, and then you have to fight them all. I mean, idealistically, that's a neat idea, but... I don't know. Oh, they all give loot. Cool! I'm glad this is happening. Can we please not... Oh my actual god. I'm actually really pissed off now. Like, that's fucking retarded. Like, honestly, that's fucking ridiculous. They built this specifically to be a shitstorm. Just... because everything knocks you back, like, 10 feet. It's so annoying. I don't know how you're supposed to fucking do this without getting knocked off the map 36 times. Yeah, they just chain knock you off the map. Oh, that's right, he has this stupid mechanic. I like how I'm really never in control of my character because of how much I get knocked back.
That felt old. A splinter out of time.
How many more of those things does he have? He should be... he should... be out of this stuff. Glad that happened.
Express lane is open. No.
God damn it.
You are go for lift off.
I guess these things are all crits, which is kind of nice. Dude, stop!
Wasn't emotionally prepared for that.
I don't want to be fighting in this middle arena because of how knockoff it is. Like how easy it is to get knocked off. I'm actually kind of terrified that I'm going to get knocked off the whole time, and it's just bleeding my lives for when I need to be using them later. Like, right now, when I'm, like, nearly off the map, and that's just part of the fucking... I can't get out of this. Okay, so, in a perfect world, it stops doing this, but...
I'm afraid it's not over yet.
Yeah, that, what he said. So. I mean, it's nice that the timer's not going anymore, because if the timer was still going, that would be fucking ridiculous.
This had better be worth it! Ah!
I bought all the turrets, I think. At least I thought I did. I did. It's just gonna keep moving around the- oh my god. Why? Why would you do that? This is so bad, dude. Like, frustratingly bad. No wonder there's turrets all over the place. Holy shit, they actually did this. This was what they did. Someone chose for this to be the method that you use to do this. This was someone's idea. Holy shit, why?
Closing my eyes! Oh! Wasn't emotionally prepared for that.
That's my only question, is why. That.
Never mind. Oh! Get out of my way! Mentally and emotionally.
Really? Really? Alright, cool. So, I have to go around, collect crystals from various places, and then use them to buy turrets, and hope that the turrets are at the places that he's gonna teleport to? I don't know, man. That just seems like a really just half-baked idea. Wow, I'm actually, like, severely upset with the way that this campaign went. Like, the end of this is just, like, I don't know, man. I'm severely disappointed with the direction this went at the end here. Man, this thing is fucking irritating.
I don't hate you, I just... you. just made up a hell, so I know where you're going. This had better be worth it.
Wandering around collecting shards to buy turrets to defeat the shields of a thing that moves around so constantly that there's really no point in even buying a turret to begin with. Man, what a good boss fight. I mean, the idea behind this is kind of neat. It's like, hey, you're gonna have to, you get to fight all the bosses you already fought again. And it's like, you know, on paper that might sound a little bit stupid, but I mean, this could have been really cool. You know, the idea of Rendain using all the bosses you already fought and having to fight them again. Like, that's not a bad idea. But the fact that they retain every bit of their mechanics, and all their mechanics are fucking irritating. Like, on their own, it's not bad, but when you have to fight every single one of them, it's like, why? And if I remember correctly, eventually this thing just stops teleporting and just fights you. Like, is it done teleporting now? It seems to be done teleporting.
To the void that wrought you.
Better not fall off the fucking map. I'm gonna be mad if it knocks me off the map. Almost.
Sweep in with the tide.
Like I was saying in the last video, you can stick Alani's ultimate two things like I just did. Which is kind of neat, actually. It's a pretty neat ability that she can stick stuff to people. Okay, one of the flaws I'm seeing here, again, or still, I guess, is that it kind of forces you to stay close to the boss so that if you get knocked off, it doesn't throw you off the fucking map. Like, this is about to probably launch me off the fucking map. But the bosses all have, like, they don't want you close to them. Man, it has had no health for the longest time. Holy Christ, that thing had no health for the longest time. Are we back to fighting Rendain?
Solus is doomed. There is nothing you can do. There is nothing any of us can do. Submit to the inevitable!
We're fighting him again. Ow. Oh, Christ. They really gave him a fucking attack that removed your ability to use ultimate.
Surge forward.
Thank you. I'm glad that I have some knock-up abilities, though. No, you're not killing me. I do not want to die.
Your face makes me need a shower.
Guess I'll be down here then. Where the fuck did he go? Hang on, pause. Let's do time on the trail. Where is he at? Oh. And I'm off the map. Okay. Guess I'm not off the map. I'm going over here.
Still the mind. Pretty low on the food chain.
He's at about a third of health.
Opportunity to look inward.
Interesting.
Heat his wreck.
Interesting. He prioritizes the turret. Huh. That should be it. Do what? Whoops. I turned away. I wonder if it was bronze. Cool. Okay. Let's talk about Battleborn for a minute. I'm not gonna go on for a while because you guys kinda know how I feel about this already, but campaign could have been better at the end. My main problem with Battleborn's campaign or story is the first, like, two or three missions, even, like, three or four missions, they felt unique and individual, and they felt special. But as it got near the end, like, the last four, especially, like, the last couple that were all just basically horde mode, and then just sacks of health bosses. Like, the Rendain fight was interesting, but it wasn't, maybe it, I don't know. I can't tell if it's just, like, I'm not in the mood to play this, so I was being extra critical of it. I did feel like all the knockback was a little excessive, and that the fact that basically all of my lives in that, except for, like, one, were lost because of being knocked off the map. Except at the end where I, like, got knocked back on, which was kind of cool. But I feel like they built that to be the most frustrating thing possible, and that's unfortunate. All in all, I think it was a really, really good campaign. Like, the story was good, and, like, you felt like you were actually helping and saving something, which it's always good to have that feeling of, like, you're actually doing something, even if, because video games and stuff like that, they're like books and movies. Like, a video game is, like, you are the main character, and it feels nice to, like, be in control of what's going on, even relatively. Like, you know that, like, if you don't do something, it's gonna fail in, like, the universe. So, it was nice feeling that, like that intense, like the intensity of the campaign, and I liked that. I just didn't like how they incorporated, like, the most annoying bosses in the game into the final boss fight. Like, I think a conservator would have been really cool at the end there. Like, if they spawned the conservator at the very middle and then they, like, threw the things around, you had to, like, run around the map and, like, break the things before the conservator's, like, death field got to you. I think that'd have been really cool because that would have utilized the map really well. But instead they use, like, the other Varelsi thing, the Gun Hulk, which, like, it takes so long to kill because of the turret thing. I think that if they had used a conservator instead of a Gun Hulk, it would have been a much better fight. And maybe not have used the Thrall. But I don't know. I feel like the Varelsi were more involved with Rendain than the Thrall were, but who knows. But all in all, it was good. It was good. I'm getting like vibes of like pre-sequel from it because it's like the story is good, but like the way they made it is just, it feels off. But I liked it. Overall, I did like it. I think if I was in, like, a really big mood to be playing Battleborn and I was, like, excited to finish it, I sat down one night and finished and, like, played it with, like, a buddy of mine, I think I would have loved it. But it did feel like it trailed on forever. But this is the end of Battleborn. The next thing I'm doing is Fallout Far Harbor, I think. I hope I'm doing that. I'm not actually really sure. I have to get back into a mood for Fallout. I'm on a Dark Souls 3 kick. But that's Battleborn. That's probably the last you'll see of me playing it, unless, like, new heroes come out and I play some multiplayer with some buddies. But that's going to be it for me for Battleborn. What did you guys think of the story if you played it? If you didn't play it and you were just watching me play it, what did you guys think of what you saw vicariously playing the campaign through me? That's fine. But what did you guys think of the campaign if you played it on your own, or if you played it through with me? What did you guys think about it? And... yeah, that's about it. Thank you guys so much for watching this series. Battleborn is now coming to a close, relatively. But yeah, thank you guys all so much for watching. And yeah, until the next video, have a great day, everyone.